Welcome to Sketching with Gretchen. We're going to do watercolor with markers today. So what you're going to need to get is a piece of paper. I'm using just a half sheet today. You're going to need a pencil, a Sharpie, or a black pen. You can use a black ink pen if you don't have a Sharpie. Ask your parents' permission to use their Sharpies. You're also going to need a baggie or plastic wrap. Water-based markers, you can use Crayola. Crayola's water-based markers. These are some silly scents. They're also Crayola. These will work as well. They have to be water-based. Sharpies, colored Sharpies, will not work as well with this project. You're also going to need some sort of spray bottle. Okay, so what you'll need to do is come up with a design. And the design I did to start this drawing, I have two actually. So I'm doing this lesson for my fourth and fifth grade. However, if you're in a different grade or if you're a parent, you're certainly welcome to try this as well. Anyone can do these. So my first drawing I did is a garden scene, and I've already drawn it out in pencil. And for those of you, for the boys out there or the girls that aren't interested in flowers, my other drawing is of monsters. So I'm gonna go over my lines for both of these in Sharpie. You're gonna need to do that before you do any sort of painting. So since I'm working smaller, the Sharpie I'm gonna use is my ultra fine point Sharpie. Now, if you're using a bigger piece of paper, you might be able to just use your fine point Sharpie. What you wanna keep in mind though is, however big your drawing is, you're gonna wanna stick with a similar size of bag. So if you wanna draw bigger, then you're gonna need either a bigger piece of plastic wrap or a bigger baggie. So my baggies might be a little bit narrower than my paper here, but I'll just have to adjust them accordingly. That's kinda how I do things as an artist. Sometimes I figure out as I go along. This one will work fine. Either keep your paper similar to the size of your baggie. All right, I'm gonna set my baggies aside and trace around my lines. Don't get too caught up on details. Now the flowers I did are just simple line flowers. And you can just make them up as you go along. So if you start out with a small dot and put a couple circles around that dot, what I would call concentric circles, and add a stem, instant flower. So just be creative. And again, they don't have to be perfect. The stem's gonna go all the way down. I also added some grass at the bottom, so if you'd like to do that, you can. You can really make this picture anything you want. You'll see after we do the painting part how it's going to transform our drawing. All right, I'm gonna work on this tulip here. A tulip is simply a U-shape with some jagged lines up at the top, and then I just added some of these interesting details in. So you can just make these up. Another thing you could do is, if you have flowers in your yard, go out there and take a look at their petals, the shapes, the designs, and try to make them look like those, but keep it simple. Keep it simple. Got a butterfly up here, so I've got kind of a small hot dog shape and then a couple curved lines on the side to make the wings. If you think of it as a number three this way and then a backwards three this way. probably come up with some ideas. If you look around your house, you might find some flowers. If your mom has flowers out in the vase, got a little bee here. All right, these down here I drew, and after I drew them, I decided they look like weeds. But every garden has a few weeds, right? Mine does. If you don't go exactly over your pencil lines, don't worry about it. We're going to erase those before we paint. Try to get creative. Try to come up with some different flowers. It can be challenging. All right, our last flower here. Stem, just a curved line down to the bottom, a couple leaves on the side, and that one's finished. So I'm gonna go ahead and erase my pencil lines. That one's done. Now my other one, my monsters, I'm gonna do this in my thicker Sharpie. I think it has a pretty good point. Prepare for painting. Actually, I'm going to put these aside. Now you're going to need your plastic baggies. We'll just do one at a time here. So with your plastic baggies, you're just going to have them laying flat, and all you're going to do is just add some color. So we're going to start off by adding color to our plastic, and I'm just going to kind of randomly put color down. Now when you color on the plastic, it's not gonna color in completely. It's gonna actually puddle up, or bead up if you will, and not cover the plastic completely. It's not gonna coat it completely. That's okay. That's the way it's supposed to be. Just fill in some color here and there. Ooh, these smell nice. Smells like grape. You might end up mixing some colors. That's okay too. Actually, I might do my grass down here. I'll start with the yellow. And what do I add to make green? I add blue. So I'm gonna get a little bit of blue down there with the yellow, and I might go back over it with my yellow actually. So, and I'll really get some green. Look at that. Okay. Throw some pink in here. Don't worry if it mixes, don't worry. Some colors might change to a muddy color, but this is all about experimenting and trying new things. So, I think I've got enough blue on there. You can see there's no rhyme or reason to what I'm doing here, really. Just gonna fill in as much of the color as you can. Okay. And you don't have to create, it looks like I kind of created an image here, but you don't have to create any kind of image. I'm gonna bring this up closer so you can see how it beads up. All right, once you have the color down, then you're going to take your spray bottle, and we're just going to hit the plastic wrap or baggie with a couple squirts of water. Don't, just a couple, two or three, just enough to get some puddles. And then you're gonna take your paper and position it over your plastic wrap and just give it a little press. Kind of see the, some of the color coming through here. Peel it up. And there's our beautiful flower garden. Okay. Now we'll do another one here. You can really reuse that plastic baggie. So if you take a paper towel, you can clean that off. I'm just gonna work on it just like that. So I've got my monsters. I'm gonna do my monsters next. So with my monsters, I think I'm just gonna make a couple. This guy is gonna be red. So I'm gonna put a blob of red there. And again, I'm kind of thinking in reverse here. Because when I put this down, face down, you can see that my tall monster's on this side. But it really doesn't matter. Just want to get the color down. You can make all kinds of prints with plastic bags like this. All right, I'm gonna put some grass down below for them as well. And I'll make their background kind of gray. I'll just put a gray color. I might even throw a little sunshine in there. Okay, give it a little spritz. One, two, all you need. Now, I'm not gonna get my whole paper because I made my drawing longer. So I think I'll just put it down like this. Give it a little press. And I could do this next half, this other half over here. I add some more purple and gray. And green. Put this back down to make that last part of my print. There we go, kind of finishes it off. So there's my monster. There's my monster art. So give it a try. There's all kinds of things you can really do. It's, we're really just playing around with materials and using what we have at home to make and create. So have fun with it. All right, we'll see you later.